Hello, I'm Ilyan St-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to install MeshCentral on a Raspberry Pi. MeshCentral is a cloud service, but it is also very compact, runs on Node.js, and you can install the entire MeshCentral server on a single Raspberry Pi. And this is, of course, a well-known device. It starts at $35. This one, I put a nice MeshCentral sticker on it, and it has a case that is fully metallic, so the case is also a heatsink. In any case, I want to install this on MeshCentral on a Raspberry Pi because I can put this in a closet somewhere and manage all my home computers using this device. So we're going to take a look at how to do that now. So now, of course, I usually have my normal, developer machine, but instead we are going to use the Raspberry Pi that's in the back of me. And actually I have it right here. It's a white box next to the screen. And I'm going to be using a Raspberry Pi 4 with 8 gigs of RAM. So now before we start, I want to go to my desktop here. This is my developer machine. And I want to take a look at this little cheat sheet that I created. So what we're going to do is we're going to have Rapsian already installed on the Raspberry Pi. So this is a default 32-bit OS that is generally available. Normally, you would use the operating system without the X graphical user interface if you want to be very efficient. And so that saves a lot of RAM. And so you can, more space for MeshCentral to run in. But in this case, for this demo, we're just going to use the Rapsian with the X UI just for fun, but the same steps apply if you use the non-X shell-only operating system. So what we're going to do is we're going to open a shell on the Raspberry Pi, and then we are going to do apt get update. This will update all the repos of inside the install. Now, I've already done this command because it can take quite a bit of time. And then we're going to do the rest of the commands here. We're going to do sudo apt get, and we're going to install Node.js and NPM. NPM is, of course, the Node package manager. Then we're going to create a folder called MC or MeshCentral or whatever you want. And then we're going to do NPM install MeshCentral, and we are going to run it. And then we're also going to look at how to install and uninstall MeshCentral as a service in the background. So let's go and do that. So what I'm going to do is switch over here. So by the way, I have both my developer machine on the upper left screen here, and I have the Raspberry Pi on the bottom right. So I'm going to focus on the Raspberry Pi, and the first thing I'm going to do is open a terminal shell. Now, I've already enabled SSH on this Pi, and of course, I've already done the sudo apt get update, so just to update the repos. So now what I'm going to do is do sudo apt-get, and I am going to do install and Node.js and NPM. So we're going to do both of these at the same time. Of course, lots of dependency packages. We're going to say yes here, and up it goes. It's going to start downloading and installing all those packages. It shouldn't take too long. And I checked previously. Right now, Rapsian, the default node that comes with it, is version 12 point something. Now, this is great. Anything 12 and above for MeshCentral is wonderful. MeshCentral will run on 10 and above right now, although SSH will require 11. So really, you should have 11. The best is 11 or above. But 12 is great. There are ways, if you go online, to install the latest Node.js version 17, as I'm recording this, on the Raspberry Pi, but we're not going to do that. We're just going to download the default one. So there we go. It's installed. I'm going to do Node.js-V just to confirm, I have version 12.22.5 right now. And then we can do npm-v, and that will tell us the version of the Node Package Manager. Okay, so now we are ready to install MeshCentral. We have Node inside installed in the Raspberry Pi. So I'm going to create a folder called MC, make direct and cdmc. You can call this folder anything you want, and that's perfectly fine. And then I'm going to do npm install mesh central. Really, if you want to tell somebody how to install mesh central, and they know about, they're fairly good with computers and so on, all you have to tell them is npm install mesh central. And like they'll be like, ah, okay, that's really all you need to know to install mesh central. Okay, so it's downloading the MeshCentral package. It's also downloading the base dependencies. But as soon as we're going to run MeshCentral, MeshCentral is going to install more dependency packages. So here we go. We have all the packages added, zero vulnerabilities found, which is always a good thing. So now node and node underscore modules and slash MeshCentral. Now what you always want to do when you run MeshCentral is always run it from your MC folder or your this root folder. You don't want to go inside a node modules folder and MeshCentral and run it. You always want to run it from this location. That's the best. And so now what you're going to see is it's downloading the extra packages like Archiver and so on. These packages will depend on the platform you're running, and also it will depend on the features that you have in your config.json file. So of course, if you enable Let's Encrypt, for example, then this will install more packages. Now the other thing is, the first time you run it, you will see that it will create all these certificates. So you have right here, you have certificates for the agents, for TLS, and so on and so forth. So that's only happens the first time. Now, another thing that's that I noted here is that MeshCentral is currently running, but it's running as not as root. And so what's going on is that when you're not running as root, you don't have access to port 1024 and below. And so MeshCentral is running on these, well, actually 1023 and below. So it's currently running on 1024 and 1025. So I'm going to do Control C, and I'm just going to sudo run MeshCentral. So I'm going to run it as admin on the Pi, and this will run MeshCentral with the proper port. So now you see port 80 and port 443. Excellent. So now, actually, before I do this, I can type ipconfig. Let's see. Ifconfig. I'm on Linux. And you can see the IP address of the machine. Let's see right here, 131. So I'm going to run MeshCentral again. But now I know the IP address of the machine, of my Pi, so I can go back into my desktop machine, and I can try 192.168.2. I think it's, was it 131? Yes. So I hit enter. And of course, because it's a self-signed certificate for TLS, it is not trusted cert, so you get this warning. I'll say accept the risk. And boom, you are in your own MeshCentral instance. Now, of course, if I go back to MeshCentral, it should say the server does not have any users, so the next account to be created will be administrator. So what I want to do then is go back here, and in the login screen, I can say create a user, type admin, email, I can write something bogus here, and then admin, for example, and say create. And so the first user will be administrator for the system. And so when you're fully administrator of the system, you get to see things like this panel here and so on. You get to see like the user management and so on. And of course, I'm the only user. Okay, and I can switch this to out of night mode. Let's go light. There you go. Perfect. And so I got my server running. Now, a few things to note here. First, I'll go back to the Raspberry Pi. The problem with the way this is running right now is that if I close the shell, then the server will stop. Or if I hit Control C, the server will stop. So this is great to debug that the server is running, to change your configuration and things like that. But now, let's suppose I want to run it like for real, like I'm about to put it in my closet to, on my server rack or something. I can't run it inside the shell like this. So what you're going to do is I'm going to go to the Raspberry Pi here. And by the way, as soon as I do Control C, of course, the website just goes down. But now I'm going to do node. I'm going to run MeshCentral dash dash help. And what you're going to see if you do dash dash help is that there's these commands to install and uninstall MeshCentral as a background service. So on Linux and Windows, this works on both OSs. Of course, the implementation is completely different. Windows uses Windows services. Linux uses systemd. But now I can do MeshCentral dash dash install, hit enter, and boom, it's running. And so now I can close the shell, right? It's running in the background. So I'm going to go back to my my browser, and actually we can see that the page is just loaded. I can type admin to log in, and I am logged into my own server, and it is now running on the Raspberry Pi in the background. Not only that, but if you turn off the Raspberry Pi, plug it in your closet or server closet or something like that, then the MeshCentral will automatically start up when the Raspberry Pi starts up. So you are kind of ready to go here. Now, a few other things I want to mention. Two of them. One is that I'm currently running MeshCentral in LAN mode on that Raspberry Pi. So, for example, if you click on the console here and you type info, you'll see that run mode, it's in LAN mode. And in LAN mode, what happens is that the server has no fixed IP address. So now you can move your Raspberry Pi to the server closet or so another network, and it will get a DHCP address. And the agents will multicast on the network to find the server and connect. So this is good for managing your local network. Obviously, if you want to go to the cloud, you'll have to switch to WAN mode, put a DNS name on the server, and so on and so forth. But for now, this is great. This is LAN mode. What I want to do is show off this little tool I have, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. But I have this tool called MeshCentral Discovery. And when you double click on it, it's a little Windows tool that goes in the system tray. And what it does is it multicasts to find all the MeshCentral servers on your network in hybrid mode or LAN mode. So obviously I have three here. So this is why there's three. And you can configure the name and the this substring here in the config.json file. I believe it's called discovery or something. And you put the strings you want there. So you could put like MeshCentral Raspberry Pi or some meaningful name. And then let's see, you can click info. Actually here, the second one is 131. So once you have that, you can click on this and it will just open the browser on the server. So if you're in LAN mode and your computer, your server does not have a, your server does not have a fixed DNS name and you don't know what the IP address, you can use this little tool and, you know, basically find your server and click on it and open the page. So that's useful. It's basically a human version of the discovery tool that the agents also use to discover the server. Okay, so that's one thing. And then just to top it off, I have one extra prize here, one extra fun thing. There's an icon here. If you click on the My Server tab, there's an icon on the upper right. And you may have noticed that I have like a really nice Raspberry Pi with a sticker and so on. Well, what I do is I have a picture. I actually have it's just a little JPEG I have. That of my Raspberry Pi with my little picture and so on and so forth. So one neat trick is that I can replace this picture here very easily with whatever picture you have you want. So what you do is you create a picture, a file called server.png. Let's see here. And what you do is you put it in MeshCentral.data. So I have this WinSCP. I'm going to go to MeshCentral, go to MeshCentral.data. Okay, so this is all the folder, the certificates, the config file for the server, and so on and so forth. By the way, always back this up. If you're going to do production servers or whatever, always back up this folder and store it in offsite. But what I'm going to do is drag and drop my picture that I have right here. I'm going to drag and drop it into this folder. It's called server.png. And then if I hit refresh, there you go. The picture is right there. So it's just a nice way to customize your server and to make it look nice that now you know you're actually running on a Raspberry Pi when you log into your server. Otherwise, the server runs exactly the same as any other servers you can imagine on AWS and so on. One of the great things about the Raspberry Pi is that the later units, the Raspberry Pi 4, they are fairly beefy. You can get the OS without the X Windows. It leaves almost all the memory available for MeshCentral. If you have an 8 gig version, this is quad core 64 bit. This is probably more beefy and more powerful than a lot of AWS instances you could get for a moderate price. So really exciting. This is a video I've been wanting to do a long time. Basically being able to use a Raspberry Pi as a server for managing all your devices in your home. I think this is great. I use it myself and I love it. Thank you very much. Have a great day.